The following is a special presentation of Henrico County Public Schools. Live coverage of the Varina Blue Devils as they take on the Hermitage Panthers.
Welcome to Glenn Rudisell Court here at Varina High School, home of the Varina Blue Devils. We've got varsity boys basketball action coming to you live streaming as the Varina Blue Devils play host to the Hermitage Panthers. I'm HCPS TV's Will Catterly, and joining me are two of the talent from the Center for Communications and Media Relations here at Varina High School. That's right, they have a center for that. Joining me to my right, Aaron Brown, and to my left, Samuel Grain. Guys, appreciate you being part of this program, part of this high-flying action basketball game we're going to have tonight up and down the court. It is going to be absolutely crazy. Aaron, let's start with Varina. Defending, two-time defending state champs, coming in with a record of 12-1. And matter of fact, their only loss was out of state. How does Varina make it 10 wins in a row? They're off nine straight wins right now.
That's right. Well, with a great player like KJ Weiss bringing in an average of 20 points per game, this star player has got a great energy on the field tonight. And also joining is his brother, Caleb Weiss, in number three with 7 points. This brother duo brings in a good 30 points per game. A fantastic thing to have on the field, if I do say so myself.
Yeah, on the court, they are a fun dynamic duo. KJ, the senior, he scored 33 points in his last game Friday at home here against Henrico. And his freshman brother, Caleb Weiss, they are fun to watch. And look out for Malachi Cosby down low, averaging over 8 boards, 9 points a game himself. He'll get into double digits as well. Really, everybody on Varina can score.
That's right. This is
a deep star-studded team. And there you see Malachi Cosby, senior small forward, 6'3", 230 pounds. He is a load and an enforcer down low. They're going to have to counter him inside. But outside, Samuel, how does Hermitage stay in this? They've got athletes of their own, and they come in with a great record at 11-5, even though they've lost 3 of 4.
Hey, that you guys might have KJ Weiss, but we have Eden Harvey, who is getting 18 points per game, and it looks like he's the one that's been carrying this team through this even this season. He's going to have to step up to help win this game.
Eden Harvey can get hot. I've seen him in person do it. If he gets hot from long range, he's tough to beat. It's a great yin to the yang, Eden Harvey versus KJ Weiss, and down low, Malachi Cosby going up against the big man for Hermitage and Cavante Williams. Well, let's meet the third member of our crew. That's right, plenty more center kids we've got here working with us tonight. Let's go down to Nona Walther for more.
Hello, my name is Nona Walther, and today I'm here with
Ronnell Robinson.
So, Ramel, how long have you been attending Varina High School?
I'm a freshman. This is my first year here.
Okay. What are you looking forward to during this game?
Mainly for us to get like a 10-point lead in the first quarter. By the end of the game, we should at least win by 20.
Okay. Who do you think is going to bring out the most energy on the court tonight?
I don't really got no specific name. It depends on who don't get first, real.
Okay, guys, you've heard it first from a real Robinson, and I'll bring it back to the desk.
You know, she's not wrong. Usually the dunk does bring the house down. You know, that kind of gets the momentum going. That gets the energy flowing. And it's definitely something that Hermitage is going to want to have to deal with. They're not going to want to deal with it, but they're going to have to deal with it if they want to stay in this game. We talk about runs, you know, in sports, it's a game of runs, especially in basketball. Varina will have those 5, 10, and hopefully not for Hermitage's sake, 15-point spreads. As you see them getting ready, they are loose, and they should be. One loss on the road. They have not lost in their home building tonight. And we're getting ready for the starting lineups, but we've got some inside info for both Hermitage and Varina. Aaron, you actually saw KJ before the game, and we'll get to this in a moment because we're going to go right to the national anthem.
All right.
Thank you.
Very patriotic, that national anthem there.
Absolutely. I love the finish there. We are just moments away from tip-off between Varina and Hermitage as they do the starting lineups. Aaron, I did want to mention briefly, as I did just before the national anthem, you saw KJ Weiss before the game, and he said there's a couple other players besides him and his younger brother, Malachi Cosby, who might have a big impact in this one.
That's right. He warns that number 5, Dominique Coleman, and number 23, Brian Mitchell, are going to be great on the field on this court today. Brian Mitchell today has 9 points per game and 6 rebounds. An impressive, well-rounded stats, if I do say so myself.
Absolutely. Those are the little things that you want your team to do. Meanwhile, Hermitage, on the other end of things, they're going to need some key contributors besides Eden Harvey. And we talked about Kevontae Williams, but their other probable starters are going to have to come in big, aren't they?
Oh, yeah. Looks like we've got a bunch that are going to be probable starters. We have Makia Murray on forward. We have Omar Washington.
Yep.
We got Jaden Faircloth. This looks like these are going to be some good staters today.
And Jaden Faircloth is listed as a point guard. Eden Harvey more of a shooting guard. So we'll see how that transpires. Both teams love to get up and down the court. And even Sean Robertson from CBS6 is here getting the intro shot for his highlights tonight for CBS6. How about that?
Great to see him.
Absolutely. Absolutely. So Varina, they're starting 5. As we would expect, KJ Weiss and his brother Caleb Weiss, number 3. Number 2, Damari Carter out on the floor. Number 23, Brian Mitchell. And there's the big load we talked about, Malachi Cosby, 230 pounds. You might think he looks like a football player because he is. And Hermitage hasn't even come out on the floor yet. They're playing a little mind games. See, they're starting 5. As Faircloth, Harvey, Washington, Murray, and Williams should be part of this tip. Looks like Tyson Scott's actually going to start at forward and get the tip. Number 0. So we'll jump it up, and we are underway as Varina will get the basketball and have possession. Remember, game coverage between Varina and, not Henrico, Hermitage, happening right now. Driving to the lane, up off the top of the backboard, and no, it's knocked out of bounds, and that'll stay with Varina. Both these teams normally like to go man-to-man. It'll be interesting defensively for Hermitage. That's their game. Varina's very quick, though. The feed inside to Cosby. He misses off the window, but there's the handles of Mr. KJ White with the steal and the score. Varina up early.
Our star player getting the first points of the game. What a great shot we have there.
And he had 33 against Henrico on Friday night, so he's just getting warmed up.
All right, yeah, that's right.
Here comes more of that Varina D on the floor. Oh. Watch out, here comes the break. Up and
there
in.
There we
10.
Go.
Another right into the basket.
And just like that, it's KJ Weiss 4 and Hermitage nothing. This kid is a star senior, 5'9" tall, and has yet to really rein in the D1 offers. And I know you guys are for the center here at Varina, and I'm going to be objective. I don't have a dog in this fight. But personally for KJ, this is a chance for him to show out on live stream tonight as he hits his 5th point.
That's right. He's quite a powerhouse in the game tonight and on the court tonight. It's like insane what he can do.
Good pressure in the front court, and Varina, as expected defensively, will go man-to-man on defense. Hermitage driving to the hole, stops, pops, does not hit iron, and out of bounds. It'll go back to Varina as Malachi Cosby will inbound. Back to KJ. KJ can be a point guard, he can be a shooting guard, but they like to have the senior with the ball in his hands. Malachi can shoot it, and he'll hit it.
There we go.
And a quick timeout by Hermitage. Samuel, you couldn't have a better start for Varina than you've had right now.
No, I don't think we could have with our star player getting the first point out of the game.
Saw a 49ers fan. He's still happy from last night. Saw him for a brief second over there watching the game. Yeah, fast start for Varina. Definitely not what Hermitage wanted to see on either side of the ball, but something that Varina is very capable of. And here's a replay of it again. Watch this, guys. I mean, that didn't hit iron, did it?
No, it went straight through that hoop.
Perfect swoosh.
Malachi Cosby delivering. Again, 6'3", 220, and he can shoot a three-pointer. That's a nightmare to defend on defense.
Yeah, no,
don't discount Hermitage too early, though, Will.
Oh, I'm not discounting them at all. They're talented. They are uber-talented.
But Malachi has some really well-rounded stats, as do a lot of players that Varina have here.
Well, as we know, this is a defending state champ for a reason, two-time. Now, they are Division 4, or Class 4, I should say. I like to say Division. They are Class 4. Hermitage is Class 5. These two teams cannot meet in the playoffs, therefore, because they're in different classifications, which means both could win a state championship in the same year. We've seen that with Varina and Highland Springs.
That's right.
Hermitage takes it up, trying to get on the scoreboard now. Eden Harvey with KJ all over him. Harvey's going to try to get open. He is. He usually shoots that three. They close down on it well inside. And there's one of the men we were talking about, number 21, Cavante Williams, gets Hermitage on the board.
There's that uber talent.
Quite an impressive layout I saw there.
And here we go again. Now it's Hermitage going the other way. Dunked through the middle. Unbelievable play.
Dunked right on him.
Absolutely. Tyson Scott. Athleticism. And here comes Hermitage again. A ball on the floor. And the possession will go to Varina. 8-4, Blue Devils. I told you the action would be fast and furious.
Yeah.
Only about like 5 minutes into the game, we already have a slam dunk.
Oh,
there's
our
pass inside to
replay.
Williams. Nice job by Williams. You see him use his big body to get position underneath, and that's well done. Even against Malachi, and we said that'd be a big matchup. Malachi and Williams down low. Can Hermitage win that enough to stay in this game? Here comes Cosby saying, I got offense too. Oh, scoop off the iron, no. Hermitage the rebound. Both these teams like to get out and transition and go fast. Varina back defensively. Screen set up the top. Nowhere to go at the top of the key. Here comes Eden Harvey. Quiet so far, but it's early in the first with 5:30 to go and counting.
Here's where they find the opening.
Nice pass inside, but that's covered up. They'll go up, shoot anyway. Draws short iron, and the rebound comes down to one of the littlest guys on the court. It's number 3, Caleb Weiss. The younger brother, stutter step move, no. Rebound goes to Hermitage, and the Panthers in red will go the other way now. Here they come, driving.
Great back-to-back as they come back down here now.
Yeah, open Jay. He'll shoot it, and he'll hit it.
And right in.
Nicely done by Tyson Scott. For two, surprise starter tonight, but he's provided some energy and some offense. Blue Devils trying to counter. Here he goes. Oh my goodness.
A nice block from the Panthers.
Yeah, KJ Weiss said, that's on me, I should have passed it out. But that is exactly what a guy of Cavante Williams' size and strength can do, especially to a 5'9 guard driving the lane.
That's right.
So the inbounds will work, but not a friendly home roll for Varina. They do, however, get the turnover, pass inside, and Malachi Cosby goes up, and he's fouled.
Some beautiful blocks from Cavante Williams.
Well done defensively by Hermitage, but you have to take care of the basketball against Varina. They're too good to give them easy opportunities.
Both teams are starting out very strong this game, if I say.
It's going to be aggressive. The ball's going to be on the floor. You know, go figure, guys. These are two football schools. They can hoop it up, too, but it's going to feel a little bit like a football game at times with that ball on the floor.
Yeah, Johnson back and forth. It's great.
Oh.
Cosby misses the first. You know, interesting rule change this year. Used to be the fouls would be counted from the first and second quarter and then restart. You'd have a single bonus at 7, meaning a 1-1. If you make your first, you get your second. And then at 10 fouls, you get 2 shots. At 5 fouls, you get 2 shots, just the double bonus, no single. And after each quarter, the fouls reset. So you don't want to get to 5, you don't want to commit 5 fouls, because then it's 2 shots for the other team automatically.
That's all right.
Malachi made the second. Hermitage on the drive.
Hermitage lays it up.
Oh, right off the iron to number 1.
Yep, back to Cosby. And the call on the floor is another foul. No, they're saying a turnover on Cosby, so Hermitage will inbound it. 9-6 our score, 4:20 to go in the first quarter. Hermitage looking, and it could be another steal, and it is. Heading the other way now.
Oh, no, just short.
No foul called either.
What an intense setup, I say.
And here comes Hermitage the other way. The three ball, no.
Oh.
Rebound by Varina, and we might have an over the back. And I think they do. They're giving it to Cosby and Varina. It was a foul.
Such a good back and forth we had there, though. Very, very good energy.
Cavante Williams, I believe, picked up his personal foul. So Cosby will inbound. Varina jumps out to an 8-0 lead, and now Hermitage has scored 6 out of the last 7 points.
Varina started out very strongly. Now, already a slam dunk in the first quarter. We really just can't wait to see what the rest of the teams will show in the rest of the game.
Beat these two teams at basketball. This is going to be a fun game, guys.
There's a team up north near D.C. that says, that, well, we beat Varina. And there's, you know, Hermitage. They can hoop it up for sure. So Varina will play against man-to-man defense once again. Cosby up at the top of the key. He'll hand it off to the hole. Little floater. Good. If it goes, and it doesn't, but he will go to the free throw line. That was little brother Caleb Weiss, who will go to the line to shoot two.
Brother Dua making a lot of shots tonight. What a great ratio we got tonight.
Since we talked football earlier, if you don't remember Caleb Weiss, all he did was, after playing in JV football on Thursday, was show up again on Saturday to step in as emergency quarterback against Highland Springs, throw 3 touchdown passes, and almost upset the Springers.
Oh, wait, I was at that game. That was a tense game.
Wasn't that something?
Really sounds like all in a day's work for that guy.
I mean, if he had won that game, everybody would remember him forever. They might still anyway. He makes the second free throw. Varina extends their lead. Hermitage bringing it up. That's Jaden Faircloth. He gets it off to number 10, Makari Ellie. And the deep three, and he can make it, but off the back iron, no. That was Eden Harvey. Quiet from Harvey so far. Here comes Williams. Like a freight train. He'll scoop and score.
Wonderful.
That's called splitting the defense right there, isn't it?
That's right.
Right down to the other side of the court.
That's called Varina
makes a
shot, but it is intercepted.
But now we're back to football. I think they're calling a foul on that one, too. Here it is again, guys. Check this out. Right in your living room, folks. Over the block attempt, too. The body control of Williams is amazing.
Especially with those 3 people all around him. He really managed to make that in.
And so far, the leading scorer for Hermitage.
That's right.
But we talked about the foul trouble as Varina up 11-8 and KJ to the free throw line. Hermitage has 4 fouls, 1 more, and it's 2 free throws for Varina, whether it's a shooting foul or not. Meanwhile, Varina has yet to commit a foul. That makes it 12-8.
Great shot from our star player, KJ Weiss.
And when he says our, he really just means for the Center for Communication and Media Relationship.
Of course.
Relations. I said relationships. Well, there is a relationship with the players.
Oh, yeah.
There's even one playing that's in your center right now.
Center really likes to build relationships. But Deion Jones, a Center for Communications native, there he learns great video editing skills and great speaking skills. But tonight he really gets to show off his basketball skills.
That's right. So we get to showcase him if he makes a big play here or there.
Hermitage
coming right back at it. The rebound by big man Williams puts it up and in. They have no answer for Williams down low right now. He's having his way. 13-10 now. Varina brings it back up. Cosby at the top of the key. Hands it back off to KJ. Never a bad idea.
And right in the basket.
KJ is proving his top of the team stats.
Staying really true to his reputation, it seems.
He's a great shooter and a great passer, just a great leader. And it's Williams on the other end.
And right back to
Wowza.
I mean, you could say wowza again. Williams puts it up and in and will go to the free throw line for the and one. Watching him from, you know, courtside, he likes to talk a little bit, but it's all in good fun. Here it is again, the dish. Hermitage knows what to do right now. It's find Williams and let him go to work.
Yeah, such a good back and forth from Hermitage and Varina tonight.
Oh.
It's a very close game.
Stolen by Varina, heading to the other side of the court.
Malachi yep. Cosby, once again back on.
Blue Devils with the board, and they will get back to work on offense. They keep doing this high-low with Cosby at the top of the key. He'll set the pick, and KJ is just too open. Misses the shot. Rebound Hermitage. Panthers on the prowl. They're coming back the other way. The three by Eden Harvey. Got it.
Yeah.
And that ties up the game.
We talked about his scoring prowess before the game, and he can light it up from three. He averages 2 to 3 point shots a game, but when he's really hot, he can drill 6 or 7. Tied at 15.
There.
KJ looking for an answer. It's stolen. Back to Varina again. Blue Devils. Triple team, but scoop and score. It's up and in by Dominique Coleman.
Very heated battle. And Dominique Coleman, like KJ Weiss said, is going to prove to be a great scorer tonight.
Hermitage back with it, going the other way. As this is a seesaw affair so far in the first with 1:24 to go. Tight defense. 17-15, Varina. Hermitage lost the handle that time. Jaden Faircloth couldn't grab it, and it'll go back to Varina.
Hermitage still has a fantastic way to bring it back, only down 2 points.
Well, you couldn't ask for a better start for Varina or a worse one for Hermitage, down 8-0. But since, this has been anybody's game.
Exactly. Very heated. Very back and forth.
We got a couple of substitutions coming in. Number 23 for Varina.
Brian Mitchell. Another one, KJ Weiss, Warren would be great on the field tonight.
And getting a rest will be Faircloth. Number 30 is in, Cameron Hammond for Hermitage. Varina will bring it back in.
Giving KJ Weiss the ball. Not a bad idea.
Oh, he can create. They might call an offensive foul there for a moving screen. Let's see what they got here.
A great layup from KJ there. Getting ready to set up the next part.
I think the referees are having a discussion here because I think that's the fifth foul on Hermitage, and if it is the fifth foul, it should be free throws.
Yep, very beneficial for Varina if they make the free throws.
If that's the case, they're going to have a timeout and go talk about it. Speaking of officials, shout out to the officials. I've noticed this in football. I've noticed it in basketball. We do not have a ton of officiating. So a lot of these guys you see here, they are doing the crew for the JV game. It's the same crew for the varsity. They do two games a night, and they do it night after night. So
you never hate the refs. They do it all.
Well, half the fans do at some points, and then they'll cheer for them later, depending on what the call is.
Oh, yeah.
So it'll be Varina basketball to inbound. I guess it's not a shooting foul. So Blue Devils will take it in, and KJ going to drive and dish. Losing the handle, back up
and
with it.
Right in.
Count it and one, Damari Carter.
Well, Hermitage is not only home to amazing basketball players like Malachi Cosby, but it's home to many basketball players, including our own Chris Copeland, who graduated there 2002.
Where was I in 2002? Here's a replay. KJ just opens up the offense, and I know he loses. Damari Carter loses the handle on it. He goes right back up with it, puts it in for two, and he gets a little contact for the three-point play. So Varina increases their lead as we're in the waning moments of the first quarter, 19-15.
Great ratio, only down by 4 points.
Well, they weathered that early storm, and there will probably be another one. But for now, Coach Brian Henderson's got to be happy his squad's only down four and with the ball. Little trap, midcourt. Hermitage in trouble.
Quite an aggressive block we got there.
The ball went out of bounds. Going to stick with Hermitage, but Varina will do that. They will get out of their man-to-man defense, and they will press you at times, and it's a problem for every opponent to face.
Yeah,
three ball corner, no rebound, up and in. And Hermitage connects Makai Murray inside for two. And it's 19-17. We got another whistle.
As you said, Varina has that aggression. They really bring out their inner Blue Devil on the court.
Nicely said. We got a substitution coming in. 25 seconds left to go here in the opening stanza. They called another foul on Hermitage. The second foul on Makai Murray. Here's the replay of the rebound in the play by Murray. Great job by Murray there.
Great teamwork we got there.
The problem is he just picked up his second foul, so he'll go to the bench. And number 11, Latrell Washington, will come in. Meanwhile, at the free throw line, Brian Mitchell made his first, and he'll get a second.
Looks like he's going to make that second.
The Varina increases their lead, and Hermitage can hold for the final possession here. 22 seconds left on the game clock.
Seems those free throws prove really positive for Varina.
That full court pressure causing problems, but Hermitage finds a way. Great pass by Harvey. Oh, but he couldn't finish. Number 30, Cameron Hammond had it, but just could not finish the bunny layup. But what a pass from Harvey.
Yeah, but if that had made it in, what a fight, really. They really fought for that ball.
Great pass underneath. Either way, Hammond does get two free throws, so Hermitage has a chance to cut this to a two-point game.
Could really bring it back up.
Off the iron, no.
Just short.
Take a look again. The double team at the corner, which was a tremendous double team, and then the ball's just kind of like a hot potato, and it finds its way to Harvey, who dishes it off. A great pass, just couldn't finish. And he misses the second free throw, but gets one to go. The three on the other side, got it.
Go.
Dominique Coleman at the buzzer. You guys, are you kidding me?
Hermitage knows how to bring it back. Oh, and so does Varina, I'm telling you.
Well, and that's a football score. 24-17 the score after one quarter of play. Let's start with you, Samuel. What were you most impressed with that first quarter of play between Varina and Hermitage as we look at this open three one more time?
Oh, well, Varina does have their offense, but Hermitage brings it back with their defense. It's a tense game tonight.
But the aggression from Varina really gives them an advantage here.
Well, I saw the same thing you did, Aaron, in that their pressure caused problems for Hermitage's offense. I mean, it was a great pass by Harvey to break it. And you know right now in the huddle, that's what both coaches are talking about. Coach Brian Henderson, you see the Hermitage team huddle there. And Coach Kenneth Randolph in the Varina huddle there. Right now, Henderson is probably talking to his team about how to escape Varina's pressure without turning the ball over. And, you know, for Coach Randolph, it's like, hey, guys, you know, let's get it going here.
They can channel, Hermitage can channel their aggressive Panther side. They could really turn this game around.
Down seven after one will be Cosby, KJ Weish, his younger brother Caleb Weish, Caleb Strotter, and Brian Mitchell in for Varina as Hermitage has the basketball and Eden Harvey.
Hopefully that brother duo on the tour can really make it tonight.
There's the trap in the corner again. They get it down low. Up and no, could not get that one to roll. And finally, Cavante Williams missed a shot. Now Varina on the way. Inside, oh, the little brother. Caleb with the floater.
Like I said, that brother duo is really going to make it tonight.
Hermitage coming back. Open three. Gives it up. Takes a short two instead. Can't get the mid-range to go. And here comes Varina in transition. Up, no. Rebound. Yes. Put it back up. Muscles it. No. Cosby's there.
Oh, wow. Two rebounds. Made it right in.
And that's the thing about it. Every rebound is an extra chance. And Varina is too talented to allow them to have said extra chance. And Malachi Cosby is too strong to not make his chance count.
Varina really knows how to take advantage of every chance they get with that rebound.
You only get one shot. Do not miss your chance.
Yeah, well, it's a chance to convert what we call the old-fashioned three-point play. Malachi squares it up. He's been a factor early.
And right in.
So Cosby adds another. And here comes that pressure again, guys. You can see in the front court, Hermitage does a nice job breaking it, though. They're going to trap in the corners. And again, protect the basketball. Find a good shot, but protect the basketball. Great trap in the corner. Varina's got him. No.
Varina's guard is good.
Hermitage got through it. That was well done by the Panthers to elude the pressure as Desmond Jones gets fouled, and he'll go to the free throw line.
Breaking that guard right up, it seems. They are ready for the next free throw.
Take a look at the replay. There it is, the pressure again. The double team in the corner. That, you can't do it any better than that. I don't know how he didn't get called for traveling, actually. But a great pass nonetheless.
Such a break.
And then just smart enough to get contact. They just can't convert on the free throw, however. Well done, though. I mean, you cannot, you know, it's kind of like good on good. Sometimes you see an advantage one way or another. I think Varina's press is going to win more times than not. But that was just good on good. That was great pressure. Maybe even better job for Hermitage of breaking it. Now Varina brings it up, though, with a chance to increase their lead. Up 29-17 now, as Hermitage had a couple of empty trips at the free throw line.
That's KJ Weish. Oh, and he misses right out of bounds.
Looks like it's going to go back to Hermitage as well. Hermitage needs a bucket, though, Samuel, in a big way, because you don't want to be down by 12 because it could be 15 and 18 real fast.
Oh, yeah.
So the Panthers inbounded. See if there's any pressure here. There is.
Hermitage has got to cut through that pressure to get a win tonight.
Yeah, hopefully Hermitage can channel that speed to counter Varina's aggression.
Well, they got an open three, and you got to make them pay by hitting those. But no, rebound, though, goes to Hermitage. Second shot is in. And that is Tyson Scott. He's had a nice impact tonight, 29-19.
That's right.
So Weish takes it up. Blue Devils being patient this time around, looking for a cutting player. They got him, and there is contact and a foul. Hermitage pleading their case, but number 13 made a nice cut, Caleb Strotter, and he'll go to the free throw line. That was a nice-looking play. They just waited for a screen and a pick, and then Strotter came slicing in, and he gets rewarded by going to the free throw line. Right now, the disparity seems to be Varina is making their free throws, and Hermitage is not.
Caleb Strotter really made that shot count, if I do say.
So Strotter hits the front end, and here's number two.
Another chance. Let's see if he can make it this time.
5:44 to go here in the second quarter. 30-19, Varina and Hermitage. This game brought to you by not just HCPS-TV, but also from the Department of Communications and Media Relations here at Varina.
Really do it all.
The center. I say department. It feels like a department. The Center for Communications and Media Relations.
But it's the CSCMR who brings it to you tonight.
There it is. Including camera. Hermitage trying to bring back some offense and break that pressure and get paid for it.
That's right.
Open three ball. No, rebound, strong by Varina, and that's Brian Mitchell. He's had a nice game so far, rebounding, scoring, kind of doing a little bit of everything for Varina tonight.
Is he going to prove KJ Weish's words right?
31-19, he did. He said he was going to have a game, 31-19.
Same thing with Dominique Coleman. I mean, that man is really a man of his word when he comes to these players.
He just said it matter-of-factly, too, like, oh, yeah, this guy will, and this guy.
He's just going to go crazy.
Yeah, watch out for Brian Mitchell. Okay.
Well, right. He definitely knows his team.
He should as a senior. 5'9", senior. A lot of big D1 schools aren't sure about him because of his size, but if you watch him play and if you're watching tonight, he more than makes up with it with his passing ability, his scoring ability, his ability to handle the basketball. I mean, he does it all.
That's right.
Look at him fight and his speed. Stops, pops. That one rims out. which is rare. Hermitage on the rebound. Panthers, 4:45 to go. Three ball. Boy, they needed that one. In it goes. None of the nylon for Jaden Faircloth. And fair to say, the Panthers needed that one to drop.
That's right. Three-pointers could really save Hermitage this quarter.
They cut it to nine. Going for the steal instead. Uh-oh, here comes Varina. Gets it up and in. Damari Carter.
Such a good trade-off.
And scooping it the other way, but Hermitage can't finish. And here comes Malachi Cosby the other way. Hold on, folks. Here's a three ball. No. And off the back of the backboard and out of bounds, it'll go to Hermitage. That was almost a five-point turnaround. The missed layup on one end, if that three goes down, that's really like a five-point swing.
But what great team up from Weiss to Cosby, two of the star players of Varina tonight.
They
really giving it all.
Absolutely, and that's what transition basketball is all about. It's making a stop on defense and then turning it into instant offense. Mitchell earlier, and they wanted the offensive foul on that. Never got it.
Let's see if Hermitage can use this opportunity to break the pressure.
Well, rare 2-3 zone by Varina here. Notice how they're not guarding anyone man-to-man. They're just staying 2-3. That's two players up front, three down low, and it works with a turnover. Other way now. Scoop it, score it, got
Dominique Coleman. Right as KJ said, Dominique Coleman bringing you great on the field.
Set off the bench. He'd come out onto the court and perform, and he did right there. Timeout on the court, timeout Hermitage. And with that play moving into zone, Hermitage's coach said, uh-oh, what do we got here? Henderson calls a timeout. Varina with a 35-22 lead.
You see the KJ. Oh, there's the replay. Beautiful. You say KJ Weish on the walkways of the school, and you can know he is a big athlete. Very popular in school and on the court.
Not in size, but in mental and outgoing stature, one would say.
I'll tell you what, Varina keeping above a 10-point lead. I mean, they really went back and forth with Hermitage, but they are really keeping the lead now.
Well, that's one reason we're live streaming this on a Monday night. We knew it'd be entertaining.
That's right.
And we have you not yet been entertained?
Exactly. Hermitage really needs a plot twist to bring it back up, but they're still doing fantastic on the field. Court.
3:30 to go, 35-22. And now Varina's gone back to that press, the trap game. Hermitage has handled it well, they just haven't scored.
Such aggression from both sides here.
Great defense by Varina. Getting the steal is Dominique Coleman.
Getting that ball, getting right back to...
That's Caleb with the basketball now.
That's right, to the little brother and bringing it in.
Three ball, deep three, no. Going up, we'll see who the foul's on. I think Cosby went over the back. Yeah, they'll get Malachi Cosby for going over the back. In layman's terms, it's if the defender has position on you inside the basket and then you jump over the back, you make contact, that's a foul.
That's right.
35-22.
Thank you.
See Hermitage bring their points up. This team bringing it around.
Washington back to the top of the key. They'll spread it around. Kind of a matchup zone here. Varina really showing some different defensive alignments.
Here's Eden Harvey with the ball. Passes it over.
Eden Harvey, of course, the star player of Hermitage.
This guy's been the star down low, number 21 tonight anyway. That exactly. Shot is... wide of the mark and short. Kevontae Williams has had a strong first half, but they've changed up to zone and they've used some traps to really confuse Hermitage's offense. And when Varina plays that well defensively, their offense just does that much better.
That's right.
Here comes KJ. He's one-on-one.
Cosby defending him.
Oh, yeah. Malachi sets a screen.
KJ passes it and...
oh,
they
the
catch
rebound,
the rebound.
And they get the rebound right in. Number one, Malachi Cosby.
And the foul was called. It's Tyon Crump going to the free throw line for Varina. We saw that play earlier where Malachi Cosby sets a screen for KJ Weish, and then you have someone cutting from the baseline, and worst thing that happens is you get fouled and you go to the free throw line. That's the fourth team foul of the second quarter for Hermitage. The next one will be the bonus as well. Here it is again. See, he cuts right down the lane and contact and a foul. It's well done. You have to respect the outside shooting of KJ, and you have to respect the fact that Malachi Cosby can come straight downhill. And big steal. Lost the handle a little bit. I don't know if they call that a foul. They are saying it's a foul on number one for Hermitage. So that's on Faircloth. That's his second. And as I said earlier, now it's the fifth team foul of the quarter, so that means two free throws.
Yeah, seemed to really be stacking up the fouls this game, but it's all good. It's all part of the game.
Coleman misses the front end. 35-22 with 1:56 to go here in the second quarter. They'll make a switch for Hermitage as Jason Grant comes into the game. Coleman is second.
And that's Dominique Coleman making the free throw.
Dominique Coleman averaging about 4 points every game this season.
And he's already pretty over his number. Average in the first half.
Exactly.
Hermitage countering down low. What a move. Scoop it, score it. Kevonte Williams.
Right back to Cosby as he takes it.
And it's stolen by Hermitage again. Now they're trying to get it going. Oh, but he threw it away.
Right into the
sands.
Yeah. Be quick, but don't be in a hurry is an old saying. And Hermitage turns it back over. It was nice defense. Looking for some transition, easy offense on their own, of their own. But Kevonte Williams already has over 10 points in this one. As KJ brings it up with a minute and a half to go. There's a screen from Cosby. Cosby rolls to the basket. KJ takes it himself. Puts
and
it
make it.
KJ Weiss with the score.
There's a reason he averages 20 points per game. Great point making here.
Yeah, he's a scorer in a lot of ways.
But here's Hermitage stealing the ball. Can they make it? Oh, the pressure was too much.
No, but he will earn a trip to the free throw line. As number 21, Kevonte Williams, once again.
So far, it seems that everything KJ is saying is coming true tonight.
For Varina, it is. I am impressed, however, how Hermitage is working this press defense by Varina.
Yes, it's a great back and forth from Hermitage.
There it is again.
And the replay.
There's a double team right there. Now, you want him to pass it beforehand. Keeps that pivot foot down long enough where he's not traveling. Finds.
Really trying to find his angle there.
Finds Williams, and Williams muscles it up. And he's good at drawing. And he says, yeah, you saw. Hey, come on.
Number 21. Really?
Get another one? Okay.
There we go.
He's been all over the place for the Panthers. He'll line up the second. And make
right
that.
In.
Ball right to KJ Weish. Looking
Ball,
for a pass.
Looking for an opening here.
And he's got 55 seconds on the clock, so Varina will kind of pick and prod here, see if they can work.
Hermitage number three, proving a great guard for KJ. Yeah.
Well, they go up for the shot. It was a beautiful pass to Damari Carter, and they're going to call the foul, I believe, on Omar Washington. No. Called on Williams. That's his second. 21. So here he comes, KJ. He faces the double team, passes it, and yeah, okay. Yep, there's the foul right there. Kevonte Williams.
Varina is very impressive today, nearly gaining 40 points only in the first half. What an impressive score.
Yeah, their defense has really ratcheted up here in the second quarter.
That's right.
There's no doubt. Second free throw is short. Tipped around. Varina can't get it, but then they poke it away from Hermitage, and they do have it. So now Varina with 37 seconds left before halftime. Let's see what they can do.
Dominique Coleman going for it. And he
and
makes
Coleman
it.
Coleman makes it.
30 seconds left on the clock. Really making his time count.
And Varina now up 40-26.
14-point lead.
Need a bucket here. Looked like an elbow, but no, and it goes short off the rim. Varina can get the last shot, unless they want to go super fast. And that time, KJ loses it. Hermitage with a chance, 6 seconds left. Scooped up and blocked out of bounds. It'll stay with Hermitage with 2.8 seconds left before the half. So
that aggression as the clock goes down to zero, they're really going for it, trying to make every second count.
Well, there are no easy buckets in this one, I'll say that.
That's right.
It's all about the pressure.
Just as Billy Joel said.
We got music now. Three ball. Got it. Eden Harvey at the buzzer. Dials it in from the corner. And Hermitage needed that one.
Every second counts in this game.
You know, you say it's an 11-point game, but it was 14, and it could have been worse. That being said, Varina will take the halftime lead, 40-29 over Hermitage. And, guys, what can I say? That was a half dominated by the Blue Devils, at least when it comes to the score.
I know. The aggression was crazy from the Blue Devils tonight. I don't know what else to say over there. They were very good, and then in the final part of the second half, their defense really went up.
Samuel, your thoughts before we take a break and get ready for the second half back.
Well, Hermitage is really going to need to break through that pressure if they even have a chance of taking over the second half.
And let's go down to our talent in Noah Walther with the head coach.
Hello, my name is Nona Walther. We're here with
Coach Sweetie.
So what do you think Varina has done really good this first quarter in order to hold down their point lead?
We've created a lot of turnovers right now, so we just got to start capitalizing and making our free throws, and I think we'll be able to push the lead.
Okay. Who do you think has brought the most energy to the court tonight?
Malachi Cosby has played really well. KJ White is the state player of the year. We always can lean on him for points, for defense, for leadership. Both of those guys are seniors, so we can lean on them at any moment.
Okay, thank you. Y'all have heard it first from the coach.
Well, there's a reason why we mentioned both of those guys' names, KJ Weish, Malachi Cosby. They really have been instant offense. And KJ, like you kept saying in the first half, he was not wrong with who he said was also going to be a factor with Brian Mitchell.
And Dominique Coleman.
Dominique Coleman, absolutely.
Seems word of mouth this game tonight is really starting to be true from everyone involved.
And we're just one halfway through. We've got a second half to get to. At the half, your score here at Glenn Rudisile Court, it is Varina 40 and Hermitage 29. We'll be back in just a few minutes from live action for the second half.
That's all right.
Creates an anaerobic environment, which means no oxygen, and a lot of the biochemicals are sugars or amino acids. H2S.
We typically would, if it's kind of greenish, we'd say.
Interests are, there are reporters covering those things.
We'd like to hear more about your career.
I took a lot of journalism courses and I worked on the school newspaper, and it was really great practice.
Is it magnetic?
Yes.
Okay. So think about
Is
the paper magnetic?
No.
No. So what are your items that are?
By binary fission, and they divide very, very quickly.
It creates an anaerobic environment, which means no oxygen.
This is an analytical profile index, and essentially what it allows us to do. the Division of Consolidated Lab Services. They came into our classrooms to conduct station lessons with our students. So that was pretty much an extension of what we've been covering in our unit for viruses and bacteria.
And a lot of the biochemicals are sugars or amino acids that the bacteria can use as an energy.
Within those stations, they got the chance to look underneath microscopes. They were able to look at the processes and see how the scientists in the field actually use the equipment daily.
You can see this is clear right now. So when we mix it up, we want it to have the same.
From what I observed, the students were really engaged. They enjoyed it. They were asking great questions.
So how do you know, like, what it is?
So there's this little
It was a really valuable experience all around.
Even though we are not working with hazardous materials, we all want to simulate that environment that you see all of us garbed up for appropriately, and that's going to include a water fluid-resistant kind of gown or lab coat of some sort. Eyewear protection as well as gloves when you're working at the different stations.
Just the entire like presentation, how they arrived and had all of their personal protective equipment, I really think that it really put the students in a scientific mind frame. Like they really in that moment felt like scientists, whereas I can't necessarily with high confidence say that they felt that way before.
I usually hold it in the lab. I don't try and
My goal and my aim is to expose students to as much as possible and for them to really gravitate towards to whatever their passion is and, you know, whatever they want to pursue further interest in.
If it's kind of greenish, we'd say you probably start with negative.
Back in November, the students actually toured the Division of Consolidated Lab Services.
This is the arbovirus section.
We do two kinds of pesticide testing.
So to see where that information comes from and how they go about finding out these things and these statistics that we hear about in the media, I think, again, that was another seamless connection.
That's called an autoclave.
We have some other topics that we haven't quite covered yet. One of them is DNA and genetics. So very soon, we do plan on meeting with them again and trying to tailor another experience.
To be able to identify what bacteria we're working with.
The following is a special presentation of Henrico County Public Schools. Live coverage of the Varina Blue Devils as they take on the Hermitage Panthers.
Welcome back to Glenn Rudisile Court. Just about 3 minutes before the tip-off of the second half. Your score, Varina leading Hermitage 40-29. Aaron and Samuel joining me up here at the table. Courtside, and a heck of a first half. We go through some of the stats, guys. We talked about Cavante Williams at the opening. He has 12 points for Hermitage. We also talked about Eden Harvey, though. Varina's done a good job of holding him. He only has 6 on a couple of made threes.
Yeah.
Big-time defensive play by Varina on him. And with the Blue Devils, it's been balanced scoring. Of course, we know KJ, 11 points. His brother with 4, Damari Carter with 4, and the big body down low, Malachi Cosby, has 7. So you can see kind of the depth for Varina paying dividends. And let's talk about how that's kind of made a difference so far after one half of play.
Yeah, that's right. They're really channeling everything they have into the thing. Malachi Cosby staying true, using his size. He's getting most of the points tonight, and he's just doing an incredible job.
And they have other guys in the scorebooks as well, but those are your leading scorers after one half of play as Varina trying to stay undefeated at home with only one loss on the road. You know who used to play at home here all the time? That's head coach Brian Henderson for Hermitage. He used to go to Varina. He played for the Blue Devils. So coaching against a team he used to play on.
Using some of that Blue Devil experience to help Hermitage tonight, it seems.
40-29 will be the score when we tip off here in the third with a minute 30 to go. While we have a couple of minutes before we get tipped off, let's talk about the Center for Communications and Media Relations and some of what you guys do. Samuel, what does the department do for you guys, the communications, the center do for you, and what's your favorite part about it?
What I enjoy about the center is mostly how we use industry-level equipment to create such beautiful films and photos, and it teaches us these skills that we will use in jobs, even not media. With communications, it teaches us public speaking. It allows us to really learn in a way that we will use.
I live stream basketball. How about you, Aaron?
I went in for a completely different set of skills behind the camera, but I'm really beginning to think that with the center, it really made me discover the talent of speaking. So it really just helps you for everything in the communications field.
Well, we're bringing this game live to you in tandem with the Center for Communications and Media Relations as the two teams get ready to tip off here in the second half. Should be interesting, 40-29. And as I said earlier, it's not just the two next to me, Aaron and Samuel, but cameras. You saw Nona on the floor doing a great job, by the way. She's a natural as a courtside reporter. And we've got people, a tremendous job on replay tonight.
Right.
As well. What do we have, about 8 to 10 replays in the first half alone? That is a Center for Communications and Media Relations record.
That's right.
For a live stream basketball game. I do believe the prior record was 6.5 Ooh. Replays in the first half.
Everyone's really about beating their records tonight.
I'm just making that up. So Varina will start with the basketball and an 11-point lead. But, guys, as we saw in the first half, those leads can diminish in a hurry. They were up 8-0 early before Hermitage came back to tie it. So important for Varina, I should say, to stay aggressive offensively. Important for Hermitage to create some offense with their defense as they're trying here with some trapping near midcourt.
That's right.
So Caleb has it.
The brothers seem to be passing it right back and forth.
Yeah, it was almost an assist and a three brother to brother there. Instead, it's going to be a steal, and here comes Hermitage the other way.
Up and right in.
And Omar Washington for two.
That's right.
So the start that Hermitage wanted there with a steal and a score, it's 40-31.
Caleb has the ball now.
Yeah, Caleb has some handles as well. I asked KJ.
To his brother.
Yeah, I asked KJ who's better, you or your brother, and KJ said, well, me, of course.
Of course.
Well, sometimes a brother will say the other's better. Be surprised.
It's all about lifting each other up.
Nice pass back out. KJ three short. Rebound. Down low. It's up and no foul called. They say all ball, and here comes Hermitage the other way. It's Eden Harvey to the rack. Eden Harvey puts it up and in for two.
Impressive speed over there from that score, man.
So it's a 7-point game.
Caleb Weishe.
And he traveled.
Oh.
Let me excuse myself on that one. That was his second foul. They get called for an offensive foul there, and that's his second foul of the game. So five fouls and you're out. So two fouls on Caleb. He's going to be careful, or have to be careful, if he doesn't want to pick up his third. Eden Harvey bringing it up for Hermitage. All of a sudden, they were down 11 a second ago. It's now a 7-point game. Here comes Herm falling away, but he gets the pass away. 4-3. It's off. Rebound underneath, though. And back. The pass, no. Foul, yes. And Tyson Scott will go to the free throw line. He got the start tonight. Has been a guy off the bench in many other games, but he got the start tonight, and he comes into the second half with 6 points, and he'll go to the free throw line now to see if he can make it 7 or 8.
It's Tyson Scott with the free throw, and he makes it.
Brings us now to only about a 4-point lead for Varina. It's getting pretty close as we start the next half.
Yeah, 6-point lead. The free throw would make it 5, as you saw the foul there.
That's right.
The contact, there was some. They've let some contact go, but they called that one. It was a nice job by Scott, getting rewarded by getting aggressive going to the paint. 40-35, Varina with the basketball and the lead. Cosby, top of the key.
Hermitage really bringing it all in the second half.
What a pass to Cosby!
There we go.
Nicely done. That was KJ's passing ability we talked about.
That's some beautiful teamwork from the Blue Devils.
Star players for a reason.
Eden Harvey trying to answer for the Panthers. Finds his man. The shot is short, but the rebound. It's Cavante Williams. He's working on a double-double. That's got to be 10 boards at this point, unofficial. But he'll go to the free throw line, and We got ourselves a 7-point game. Williams will get two shots. Remember, he had 12 at the half. We got a timeout for some tying of shoes. You know what's interesting? All these players, you know, they got to wear the exact same uniform and everything. You got to have their jerseys tucked in. But if you look at their shoes, they're all different colors.
That's right.
Every player has different color shoes.
Shoes are one of the core parts of basketball. It's really what a big thing that everyone loves to have.
It's all about the shoes. You got pink shoes, you got white.
It's part of their identity as a player. What shoes do they choose?
I mean, I guess. That's really short. Rebound Varina. Blue Devils take it the other way. KJ Weiss with the basketball. Varina up 7. Hermitage has missed a number of shots at the free throw line. Otherwise, it'd be even closer. Scoop score up and in. Damari Carter scores 2, and now he's got 6. As Hermitage and Eden Harvey. Harvey's got to get hot. He's got to find some points.
We talked a lot about Cosby, but Damari Carter, again, has some really good well-rounded stats. I mean, 9 points per game, 7 rebounds on average, and 3 blocks. I mean, he can do anything.
And right now, Varine is going the other direction. Chance to do even more as they'll go to the free throw line after a great pass from Cosby to Carter. No, great point. Damari Carter has been sensational, and he's done a little of everything. You know, and just like in anything, whether you're talking sports or business or hobbies, since we're talking sports, we'll stay there. Here's the pass. And then all the way to the rim.
Right in there.
They call the foul. Makes the first free throw. But some people have a specialty. Some people can score. Some people can rebound. Some people can block shots. And then there's players like Carter who can score, rebound, and block shots. A little bit of Swiss Army knife, can do it all.
Exactly.
And in 2024, when you guys are working for a living, the more you can do, the less expendable you are, and you will hold on to your employment.
That's right.
One would hope.
Are you ready for anything?
Harvey's ready for the three, but he comes up short. Varina going the other way now. Three ball, corner pocket, no. Rebound. Up and in.
Brian Mitchell
for 2.
Once again, KJ Ward proves right about Brian Mitchell. 9 points per game this season, 6 rebounds.
And Brian Henderson wants a 30-second timeout here to discuss it. Not liking the run that Varina has gone on. Hermitage had cut it to 6. And now it is 47-35. Let's look at this replay again. The pass to the corner. They're going to get the corner 3 up. That was a late
23,
contain.
Bringing it right back.
Yep, and he's just right there for the putback. That's just getting position. That's just getting position on the defender. And he boxed him out, right place, right time, there for the rebound. Coaches love that. They consider those to be hustle plays. You can beat a team because you're more talented. Coaches don't want you to lose because the other team hustled more than you did. Hermitage will take it out, 47-35.
Varina almost ready to break 50 tonight. Second time tonight across their teams.
Yeah, JV won tonight earlier. Shot short, rebound, fought for, corralled by Varina, and they're going to want to run with it. Pitches it out.
23 takes it again.
Confident shot, mid-range J is no good, though.
Hermitage steals it right back.
Omar Washington with the ball now for Hermitage. He passes it.
Look at Harvey. Nice move. No foul called. Here comes Varina on the other direction.
Varina really channeling their aggression back that they had in the first quarter and makes it.
Channeling a good-looking shot there, too. I think that was Brian Mitchell again. So now it's 50-35. Hermitage in danger. Harvey needs this. No. Rebound. Varina.
Varina keeping their over 10-point lead. 15 points right now. Very impressive from Varina. But Hermitage could still bring it back.
Brian Mitchell with the rebound. Actually, I think it was Tyon Crump who made that three early. Brian Mitchell with the rebound. And we got a timeout on the floor. Varina 50. Hermitage 35. Let's take a look at this replay. Varina is at their best when they are running and gunning, and then they're having funnin'. Is that even a word? No, it's not.
You made it a word, Will.
That's right. We made it. We made it in reality, and it results in a three, and that was Mitchell.
And I hope all the audience in the stand and watching at home are really having funnin' tonight.
That's right. Running, gunning, and having funnin'. Cheerleaders are having fun. Hermitage is not having fun. 50-35. We saw what they did to get back in the game the last two times Varina went on a run. It was get steals, turn it into instant offense, work well on the defensive end, rebound the basketball, but you got to do it all, and they can't fall behind by 20 here. Couple of changes. Dominique Coleman is in for Varina. He'll inbound the basketball. Coleman finds KJ, who will bring it up as usual. Inside.
Mark Carter.
Up and in. Carter, his seventh and eighth point of the night.
Eden Harvey on Hermitage has the ball. Can he make it to the hoop with all the pressure around him? He cannot.
Well, it's knocked out of bounds, though, so they'll maintain possession. Harvey likes to create. He can create similar to how KJ can create. KJ been having the better of the nights, though. Inbound is good. Kickback three. Got it.
Right in.
That was Jaden Faircloth again.
And here comes Varina, the counter punch, rolling her in now.
Such a long pass leading into such a long shot. I mean, trajectory was all about that shot right there.
Well, no time to think. A transition offense, even off of made baskets. That's what Varina can do to you. So Faircloth's three negated by three by the Blue Devils. Hermitage, deep three. Eden Harvey, too long. He thought he hit that one.
Brian
here
takes
comes
the ball back.
Cosby finds Mitchell, and Mitchell is fouled. He'll go to the free throw line. 55-38 for Varina, ballooning to a 17-point advantage here in the third. .222, deuces wild here in the third quarter.
Really looks like Varina might be bringing in their 10th straight win tonight.
That was the foul on Mitchell. Good look by Malachi Cosby. They call the offensive foul on Varina this time. So Hermitage will get the ball back. They need to get something going on offense in a hurry. Looks like Varina's going to match up man-to-man. Number 15, Makai Murray is in. Faircloth will bring the ball up. Faircloth.
Great defense from Fleming, Cameron Fleming.
Nice dish, however. Faircloth keeps it alive. Over to the corner. Nice recovery by Varina defensively. Here comes a three. Got it!
Right in.
And that's Latrell Washington getting into the scorebook. They don't want Harvey taking wide open threes, but Washington cans that one. Right back, scoop and score. What a pretty, pretty, oh so pretty move by Mr. KJ Weiss.
Talk about back and forth. Really good.
Hermitage off the mark, no. Cosby the rebound and instant offense. Here we go. Got it. And that is the speed of turning defense into offense. Foul is called there, but nobody is quicker in transition than Varina. And if you miss a shot, you better get back on defense, because if you don't, what just happened, you'll see right here, happens right here. And it's so fast that we only get KJ's layup there, but Malachi, a tremendous pass. KJ with a great finish.
Also, what a jump from KJ on that thing. His knees just went right up. Agility is key here.
There's Jaden Faircloth with the foul.
I made the free throw, first of two.
Right after five fouls now. Hermitage was stacking up the fouls in the beginning, but it looks like Varina.
Yeah, Varina will get two, or Hermitage. Hermitage will have two free throws the rest of the quarter, and then it'll reset again to begin the fourth. How about Samaj? You guys know Samaj well. How about Samaj on replay tonight? doing a bang up job. All right, free throw up and in. Faircloth makes those.
JJ being first to grab the ball.
Caleb Strotter back in for Varina, along with Cameron Fleming. Some changes for the Blue Devils. They'll dish it out. Corner three, no.
Deep three, though.
It was deep, saved by Weish. Weish finds the open man, fires, no, off the back iron. Here comes Hermitage the other way.
Hermitage staying in control of the ball and makes it.
Coast to coast goes Latrell Washington. And that's two for Hermitage. And they have to make a substitution to the Panthers. Faircloth comes back in. He's spelled by Murray and Ellie. Makari Ellie.
40 seconds left on the clock this quarter.
Waiting moments of the third. Back iron, no. Offensive rebound, though. Ryan has got it back. Three ball. Round and out. Foul is called. And it's going to be on Hermitage. I believe that's on Makari Ellie. Ely. That's only the second foul for Hermitage. So Varina has a ball with 28.1 to go. Nice pass inside. Gets the friendly roll.
Herm stacking up their points in the waiting moments here.
Yeah, Caleb Strotter with two. 15 seconds, Hermitage probably going for the final shot here. 61-45. All the way to the hoop. Block, but a foul. I just called it on the body. That was a clean block on the hand of the basketball. But Jaden Harvell, make that Latrell Washington, will go to the free throw line for Hermitage. With just 8 seconds to go here in the third.
Number zero gains that free throw for Hermitage. We got on the replay here.
I mean, he got him off his feet. That was some serious speed.
Exactly.
Good. I guess you can see the body. You can see body contact there. So 61-41, last chance before the end of the half. Stolen by Hermitage. Can they get a shot off?
The speed they had there.
They count. No, it would have been no basket anyway, and did not go in anyway. And we are at the end of three quarters. It is Varina 61 and Hermitage 41.
Cheerleading going strong to their routine, it seems.
Yeah, I talked to some, we do a SportsWire spotlight podcast. Got to get one going in here in the new year, but Dylan and I were talking at Mills Godwin. We talked to captain of the cheer team there. And you know they have over 50 different routines planned. And that's just like sideline or baseline cheer.
Really prepare for anything.
And that's not even competition.
Exactly.
I mean, competition cheerleading is a serious sport. There's a cheerleader. She's not actually in costume. There she is again. See? Look at that.
There it
is. Look at those moves.
Don't got to be on the team to cheer for your team.
Samuel was doing that at halftime.
Oh, yes, I was.
That's right.
61-41. Hope you guys are having fun. Varina is. Hermitage is not. This is a tough nut to crack, Varina. There's a reason they've won two straight state championships.
Still, Hermitage is doing really well, about to break 50.
That kid's dancing, too. See, I like the little Route 5. Next time you see Varina's jersey on their back, they got the Route 5 on the back of the jersey.
Route 5 is where is that?
It's that school spirit.
You know, there are other, you know, highway roads, though, in Henrico County.
That's right.
That you don't hear other schools calling Route 133 or something.
Doesn't roll off the tongue the same.
Glen Allen isn't like US 33, right off 33.
Yeah, Route I-64 North.
That's right. Hermitage with the basketball. Varina going zone. Three ball, good.
Deep three there.
Tell you what, Jaden Faircloth. The Hermitage might be on the losing end of this, but Faircloth has been one of the winners on their side.
Really stacking up the points for Faircloth.
So 61-50, not done yet.
The layup. number four. KJ has it again.
Yeah, Varina is going to take their time and just make sure they get a good shot.
Really finding that angle there.
And that's the advantage when you have an 11-point lead in the fourth.
That's right.
KJ stops, pops, little short. Rebound, though, goes to Varina, and he goes up smartly and gets the foul call his way. So Caleb Strotter will go to the free throw line. So everybody kind of is, at least in the Center for Communications and Media Relations, kind of finding what their niche is. What you guys, young in your high school careers, you got plenty of time to figure it out. But what is there one thing that you're kind of gravitating towards?
Looks like Aaron's finding his niche right now. He is excelling at this.
He's pretty good. I think you both guys are bringing a lot.
I really just like to use my voice. It seems a lot of people like my voice.
And you got some pipes.
Tried to get into screenwriting, but didn't make a lot of scripts. But I have a lot of experience with voice work now stacking up for me.
There you go.
It's all about the footwork here on the court now. As Hermitage takes the ball.
Panthers three ball, corner pocket, got it. Oh,
in
my.
Deep.
Bakari Ealy.
Pocket.
Don't look now. We're getting down to single digits. Weiss dips it down low with a strong finish. Caleb Strotter. Panthers. Up and
nearly at it.
No good, but he will go to the free throw line. 63-53. It was a 20-point game just a few minutes ago, and it's down to 10. Hermitage won't go away.
It's all about the back and forth, and Hermitage isn't letting loose. Not in this final quarter.
Makai Murray at the free throw line. 6:33 to go. Still a lot of time left. Free throws could cut it to 8. There was the foul.
Good teamwork there, helping each other up.
Yeah. That was nice to see. Misses the front end of the two free throws. Of course, Varina's not the only one, Samuel, with the center. Hermitage has a center of their own.
Yes, Hermitage is getting a new building to their center, one of their centers, as they have three. They're getting a brand new Ace building. Ace, as very popular in Henrico, is a place where technical jobs are learnt. There is electrical, there is radio broadcasting, which is ironic for this.
They do a lot over there. I've seen the new center. It's a beautiful building.
Yeah, the A Center is a perfect way for people to build out their niches in their second half of their high school career, offered to juniors and seniors.
Looks like Varina's niche is their basketball defense, though.
Well done. See, that was nicely played. Well done, Samuel. There's a timeout on the floor.
All about those one-liners, man.
And, hey, 63-54, 6:31 to go.
Oh.
We got some flipping going. There it
wow.
is.
That was amazingly done.
Stunts and one-liners. What, are we filming a Marvel movie here?
I've once thought about trying to do flips on the floor.
I'd like to see you do some flips on the floor, Will. I did them during halftime. The camera wasn't on,
I don't want to hurt myself. I don't want to hurt myself.
Hey, watch this. Famous last words.
Right. That probably would be. So honestly, though, so 6:31 to go. It's 63-54. It's a 9-point game. Honestly, a 9-point game with 2 minutes to go is a doable if you're 9 points down. 6:31 is a ton of time. So Brian has not put this away yet. They've not put this to bed. Brian Henderson's got to be proud of his team's effort. And they're not out of the woods yet.
They're not giving up, Will.
Very even ratio.
Panthers to bring it in. They'll be Faircloth to inbound. Trying to work a screen. He had a man down low. Finds Eden Harvey, though, for three. No! And Varina on the break. up and
13
in.
Makes it. Caleb Strotter for the point there.
Yeah, Strotter was out fast in transition, as Varina does. Hermitage needs an answer. Man, they needed that Harvey three to go. Down 11, three ball, corner pocket, got it. Guess who?
Jaden Faircloth.
Faircloth now with double digits.
Faircloth seems to be the star of discussion tonight, while Eden, the star player, hasn't been talked about much, but doing close.
He's made some plays, he's just missed a lot more.
Yeah, both doing great jobs.
Varina with the answer. Damari Carter. He has double digits. Hermitage. They need answers and they need stops. 5:32 to go. Pass inside. This guy was huge in the first half. Can't make it there. Gets his own rebound, though. Up, counted in the bucket.
Beautiful by Kevontae Williams.
Kevontae Williams says, I haven't gone away yet. And we aren't finished yet.
8-point game here.
67-59 with a chance to make it a 7-point game. Let's take a look. Pass inside. There's not the double team there, so he knows he's one-on-one. Little hook shot. No, but he does not give up on it. Four white jerseys and one Kevontae Williams.
They are not giving up on that shot, and they are not giving up on this game just yet.
Here comes a second free throw. Could not convert. So all that work, and he comes up empty at the free throw line. 67-59, though. Still plenty of time. 5:13 to go.
Kevontae Williams making a lot of free throws tonight for Hermitage.
Weish to Cosby and back out. Dominique Coleman will reset. Coleman.
Ooh.
No, but a foul call. Was it on the floor or is it a shooting foul?
I think it was a touching foul. It was a little fight for the ball there.
Yeah, he'll go to the free throw line. Only the second team foul for Hermitage. Two team fouls on each side. Refs thought that Coach Henderson wanted a timeout. He did not. So big free throws for Dominique Coleman coming up. Got the first. There's that route five above the five.
Once again, Varina about to break 70, 2 points from 70.
68-59, trying to make this a 10-point advantage again. No.
Double fives miss it, but still.
Here come the Panthers.
Herm takes the ball.
Oh, almost a steal, but a foul is called as Tyson Scott gets hacked. So Hermitage will take that out of bounds with 4:51 to go. And that's a third team foul on Varina. Nice pass underneath, up and in, he scores it.
Both teams now in the 60s for pointers, for points.
7-point game, 68-61. KJY short, rebound, Cosby, yes.
Teamwork. Cosby takes.
You cannot lose where Cosby is on the floor. You have to find him and you have to box him out. Hermitage couldn't do it there. They go back inside. Ooh. Themselves. Oh, and they call the offensive foul.
Varina has now broke 70.
That's three fouls on Kevontae Williams. And what could have been 2 points for Hermitage, with Williams going to the free throw line, instead is going to be a turnover and possession going back to Varina. 4:20 to go. There's the contact. I don't know. KJ.
Sends it to Cosby. Cosby lays it up.
Nope. Rebound's good though.
Damari Carter. We got a KJ, Damari, and Malachi team up there.
Absolutely, and they're going right back to work with Williams' Hermitage. Foul on the floor, and that's going to go against Cosby. Cosby and Williams, that's been an interesting battle to watch all night long.
That's right.
That's a third foul on Cosby. Here's Varina's last possession. And again, offensive glass. Great move by Cosby. Nice defense by Williams. He did get past Williams, but then the great pickup by Damari Carter, who's done a lot of everything, kind of like Mitchell tonight has for the Blue Devils.
Despite his fouls, William is still one of the highest scorers for Hermitage. 12 points made tonight. It's pretty impressive.
Yeah, and I don't even think I updated. That was 12 at the half. I think he's up to 16 at this point, unofficial. Varina with a basketball. Under four to play now. Still, it's an 11-point game. This isn't over yet. They got to get a good possession here. KJ to the hole. That's a good possession.
KJ, going to the bucket and going to the
line. Coach Randolph has got to be proud of his team tonight.
Right.
Well, and the thing is, I've seen games where KJ just doesn't miss a shot. That's not tonight. But the thing about Weish is, KJ, he does not. He just keeps playing, and he does other things. He'll pass the ball well, and he'll still, if he can't hit his jump shot, he'll still drive to the hoop, he'll create contact, he'll get to the free throw line, he'll make great plays driving to the rim, and he's done that tonight. Big rebound for Williams, though, as he misses the free throw. Hermitage needs something in a hurry. Harvey stops, pops, no. Rebound.
Trying for the rebound, but out of bounds.
Out of the bounds.
And off who, though? I think it went off of Varina. Yeah, Hermitage will keep possession. Down 13, they need a bucket. Three ball, Harvey, right on cue. Eden Harvey with the three. Oh, and he gets a reach-in foul, going for the steal.
For that pass, though, there was a good fake-out pass, and went one, two, right there.
You know, and those are the plays that head coaches draw up and that they have their team work on, are those plays out of bounds from under the basket. Here it is. And all it is, it's just Harvey fakes one way, goes the other way. He's a catch-and-shoot guy. And he caught it, and he shot it, and he made it. He can create his own shot, too, but he excels at catch-and-shoot. Catch-and-shoot is when someone throws it to you and you just pop it off.
That's right.
And you're right, KJ at the line.
Makes it.
Right into the basket.
75-64. 3:18 to go in this contest. I don't know if somebody told a joke down there or what. But Damari Carter was acting a little bit. Second free throw, no.
Tyson Scott having control of the ball.
Scott's had a good night. And going to the basket, blocked out of bounds. Faircloth, another Hermitage Panther, has had a good night. We talked early on. We said the supporting cast for Hermitage had to be good for them to have a chance to win tonight against Varina, and they really have been, actually.
Yeah, it hasn't really been about the star player. It's been about great players like Faircloth, Tyson Scott, Devontae Williams again. Williams has been everywhere.
Oh!
Another dunk.
That dunk was so solid that it broke Microsoft Windows. Brian Mitchell just absolutely destroyed the server.
The internet was no match for that dunk.
Absolutely not. Wow. What a dunk.
That was beautiful.
Here it is again. The pass, Weish, and room service.
My God, the agility.
And that's why we watch basketball, for moments like that.
Real Spider-Man on the court there, man.
Who was the one that said the dunk would bring the energy? Of course, there's 2:40 to go in the game. But meanwhile, another missed free throw for Hermitage. It's been the free throw that really hurt them tonight.
But yeah, like I've been saying, Williams has been all over the court tonight. He has really been giving it his all tonight. You see him everywhere on the court. Can't escape him.
He's a baller without a question.
That's right.
I'd want to play with him. I mean, but you can see the talent that Hermitage has if they don't come back here. 77-64. It's still not out of possibility here.
That's right.
Kevontae Williams
makes
the
throw. If they
don't,
though, as a Class 5 team going into the playoffs, I would not want to face a Harvey team while hot with Williams down low. And if these supporting players play like they did tonight, I mean, they could beat a lot of teams. They beat almost anybody.
Managing to score 65 against a nearly 10-in-a-row champion like Varina, I mean, it's very impressive.
Oh, nearly 10 wins in a row, sure. Varina answers with the bucket. Jay is no good, but the rebound, fighting for it. Hermitage has it, still has it, goes up for it, blocked by Cosby. The rebound up and in, and Tyson Scott scores. They'll call a quick timeout here.
Hermitage nearly ready to break 70. Varina nearly ready to break 80.
79-67. It's a 12-point game. 2:13 to go. Right now, Hermitage has to come up with steals, and if they can't get a steal, commit a foul, the clock is on, not on their side. There's a steal almost, but out of bounds. Omar Washington almost came up with it. Ryan with the inbounds.
KJ taking it.
Oh,
oh my.
Knocked right out.
That was Kevontae Williams blocking KJ's shot.
Williams swatted that ball, and it almost hit Varina at the bench.
Swatted it like it was a fly. Almost hit some of our reporters down on the court.
Williams doesn't play around. Timeout on the floor. Here it is.
The only thing the players have to report to is that hoop. That's all they're concerned with.
Wow. We've seen some high-flying action tonight. 79-67 is the situation with 2:04 to go. Varina up by 12. And right now, Coach Kenneth Randolph knows, I don't want to give these Panthers another shot at coming back. Let's finish this game right here, right now. And that means take care of the basketball, hitting your free throws if you're fouled at the line, and walking out of here with a W.
Make this last 2 minutes and four count.
So Hermitage obviously going to have to bring some pressure here.
Take that pressure from Brianna and flip it back onto them.
Faircloth Scott. Nice entry pass.
Beautiful
though.
By Jason Grant.
Everyone was on him. They still managed to get it.
Yeah, Damari Carter on the layup there. Hermitage. The other way, no rebound. Malachi Cosby, who else? A little too heavy on the pass. But the guy can rebound, score, and pass, except for that one.
Oh, looks like we got an injury on Kevontae Williams.
Yeah, Williams has to limp off. Hopefully it's a cramp.
He's been doing so well today.
Been doing so well. I would hate to see him taken off the court.
Well, they're stretching his leg.
He'll be okay.
Yeah, they're stretching his leg. You know, they say the best thing for cramps is packs of mustard.
Really?
Yeah.
Where did that come from?
It's all the salt. Salt helps you hydrate fast. I mean, once you're dehydrated, you're dehydrated. But the salt from the mustard.
Fascinating.
Electrolytes. It's all about that.
I haven't come up with a mustard Gatorade then.
Well, I mean, you'll see it in football games. You'll see mustard packets, and you'll see pickle jars. People drink pickle juice.
I've seen pickle jars.
Yeah,
I have not seen mustard packets.
Yeah. It's all about the electrolytes.
Hermitage needs more than the electrolytes right now. They need points.
Need the angles.
The three. No. Rebound over the back. No foul. Putback is good.
That was Omar Washington.
Omar Washington for two. They're throwing it deep to Malachi Cosby.
And
offensive foul. They call it on Cosby. Nice job by Makai Murray initiating the contact on the defensive end. So 81-69. 1:21 to go. 14-point game. Hermitage needs to act quick. To the rack, up. No. Ooh. Rebound, Varina, and a foul as KJ Weiss corralled that one. And he will make another trip to the free throw line. Believe it or not, that's Tyson Scott's only his first foul. With 1:08 to go.
Been very good all game, Scott.
So KJ attempts to put this away. Once again, this game brought to you by not just HCPS TV, but also the Center for Communications and Media Relations here at Varina High School. We've had a lot of fun tonight. I've had fun with you guys, Aaron, Samuel. It's been a pleasure.
It's been a great night, Will.
That's awesome. I hope you guys had fun. And I hope everybody out there, we've got tons of guys with cameras, tons of kids doing camera work. I know Replay's done a solid job, audio. Do not underrate audio. It's a boring job, but it's just so important. Three ball, top of the key.
Final minute to go.
Yeah, under a minute to go, 83-72 now, and they'll call a foul, Hermitage,
In this last minute, I mean, everyone working behind the camera, I'm sure, has learned a lot, and I hope the viewers at home have learned that mustard packets help with cramps. Very interesting fact.
I hope they have learned not to mess with Varina High School.
Or Hermitage, for that matter.
Or Hermitage. They have also been doing amazing.
I've learned a little bit about myself along the way. Here's the three from the top of the key. Faircloth. What a game for Faircloth. Double-digit points for Jaden Faircloth for Hermitage. He's been tremendous.
KJ.
What would you? Let me ask you guys this. I mean, this. We got a cap on this one. 54.9 to go. Free throws. What would you say to a middle schooler who wanted to be part of the Center for Communications? Why would they want to get into it?
Oh, it's just an amazing place. I mean, I talk about this a lot, and it's a little cringy, but we're kind of a family. I mean, we stay after for games like this, amazing games like this. We have pizza together. Recently, just before we came to the game, we were playing board games. I mean, it's just an amazing place to be.
Yeah, no matter where you are in the industry, I mean, you could be some of the big prestigious directors like Scorsese, but then you find the friends you make in the industries. You know, you got your DiCaprios and all that. So building friends, building relationships, that's a core part of making this media, making sports commentary,
it's
movies.
It's not about the media. It's about the friends we made along the way.
And that cheesy line from Sam is really what we have in Varina these days.
You just compared the Center for Communications and Media Relations versus working with Scorsese. But you did it well. Both free throws are good for Varina. What a night for Brian Mitchell.
And as we get ready in the final 30 seconds, Varina about to break 90 tonight.
Foul, and Hermitage will go to the line. 87-72, 24.9. This is all but over. Omar Washington going to get a trip to the free throw line. Can't hang your heads if you're Hermitage. Here it is.
15-point lead. I'm sure Varina's about to take it home, but Hermitage can store a few more points.
I tried to do the up and under move you just saw there.
That's right.
Missed the free throw there. This is a dangerous team, though, the Red Panthers.
And we got Devils versus Panthers. How much more aggressive can you get?
Not much. Although,
KJ Williams, you know. KJ Weish with the ball.
I mean, if both were animals, if both were just predator animals, I'd say it was more even matchup.
True. I mean, let your inner panther out, let the devil out.
Well, let's not do that. It's only Monday.
That's right.
So fouls. Oh, timeout's been called. 87-73.
2 seconds left to go.
2.8 seconds. And Varina is going to win their 10th straight basketball game, move to 13-1 on the year.
And that's the end.
Will do it.
An amazing game for both teams.
Yeah, Varina never seemed like they were in serious danger. Hermitage, however, made comeback after comeback, but at the end, too much talent for Varina, too much execution. And Coach Kenneth Randolph and Varina get the win over Hermitage, 87-73. From all of us here at HCPS-TV and all of us here at the Center for Communications and Media Relations, thanks for tuning in. Have a great night. We'll see you next time.
Stay safe.